Hi, good morning. How you guys doing? So I'm the local rep. I live in Kennesaw. Chuck Dillingham, which is in the back, lives in Nashville. He's the Alation product specialist, and I'm the regional sales guy. We cover basically Alabama, Georgia, Mississippi, Tennessee. We also do Florida, but there's a different set of guys that do that. So ADJ and Alation are independent companies, but they are under one umbrella. As Global Trust is one of our products. We have American Audio as well. There's Acclaim, Antari. They make some foggers and things like that, snow machines. So it's really a big umbrella, a bunch of companies that we have. So just to kind of eliminate any confusion in there, they are separate companies, but they are kind of like one big business, if you will. So today we've got, obviously, we've got a whole lot of lights and things like that. We brought this product here. This is from ADJ. We used to be called American DJ, but we kind of rebranded the name and the company. We didn't want people to think that the product was only for DJs or for musicians. It's obviously, we're going into the pro market. We have been for a while. This is our second exploration, basically, into video panels. Alation has been doing it for years. We do have two panels that are basically for outdoor use, should you want that. The EPT, actually, the 9's going away, right? The 9's going away. So we're going to have a 6mm product is what we've had that's outdoor rated. They also have a 2, a 3, and a 5mm in the Alation, which we don't have here present. And then ADJ makes a 6mm, and then this is the new 3. How many of you are familiar with LED walls? Anybody? Or maybe one, couple of people? Okay. How many of you use video projection in your churches? Okay, there's a bunch of other hands that go up. So this is sort of the new technology. It has been now. It's kind of building as we go. When you go to concerts and you go to a theater or you go to a venue, or you go to a festival, an outdoor setting, you'll see these all over the place now. It's a little bit more feasible. Obviously, just like LED fixtures are, there's a little bit more cost involved up front, but long term, it's a better savings for you. Just like a conventional lamp, like an ETC, you got to pay like $100 or so or more for a lamp, and you got to do that every so often. Immediately, as soon as you start using the lamp, that life starts to deteriorate on it, and it just goes down from there. So you don't have to get up on a lift. You don't have to go change the lamp when you have LED. With a projector, it's the same thing. You got a lamp. There's a fan in there to cool it. That lamp life starts to deteriorate right away. This is something now that you turn it on and it basically stays on, and you're not really losing any of the output. There's a term that we use called nits that basically sort of explains the output or the brightness of the product itself. Our 6mm wall is 1,200 nits, and that's more or less kind of like a standard that a lot of the panel manufacturers are using. This one's a little bit less. It's 1,000, and it's not really that big of a difference between the two. It's plenty bright. This wall here, when I turn it on, actually I can kind of do that now, is set at about 50% output. So it looks pretty cool. Now this is a 4x2 vertical system. So you can kind of see we have some rigging bars that are, it's this little guy right here. And of course there's a shackle, and this is attached basically to the truss, so it's hanging. And the panel goes to about halfway. So right here we have a panel, 2 panels, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. You can kind of build walls as big as you kind of want. Your limitation is basically going to be your rigging points, like how much weight can what you're hanging it from support. So on these rigging bars, you can actually do about 15 panels vertical. That's what this structural component can handle. So 15 of these vertically, and then you can kind of make it, you know, as wide as you want. On our AV6 wall, you can do 20 panels, and it's a slightly bigger, the cabinet itself is a little bit bigger, but you can actually do that. You can, this is one wall, so this is a complete unit here. You can do multiple walls. We have some people that'll do a center wall, or later when they have a little bit more money, they add on, they kind of reconfigure. They'll do a left and a right, and then they'll add a center again. Some people will be creative, and they'll actually do strips with them. You can kind of just do LED video wall. You can kind of like Google it and see how people are using it. They'll actually split it up and I still make a picture out of it, so you'll have gaps in between. But from more of a scenic or kind of a creative side, they'll kind of integrate video walls as part of the backdrop in their houses of worship and on stages just for live performance as well. So let me kind of roll this so you can kind of see it as I'm going. And this is just basically a DVD that's kind of playing. I'm into aviation. My son and I like to fly.
Dreams of flying, that I could just fly. As a little kid, I just always knew that was something I wanted to do, whether I became a bird somehow, and that was just the closest thing to being a bird.
I know, I compared with Desiree a little bit. I had a barn on the back, and I used to jump off the barn.
Colors are really, really good on this, as you can see.
Oh, yeah, you can fly.
Here's the laptop that's actually running it, so you can kind of see somewhat. I don't know if your viewing angle is the same, but
wouldn't it be nice to be up there all alone in an airplane, doing what I want to do, seeing what I want to see? And that's what prompted me.
There are some feelings about flying that defy description.
So I'll go ahead and just, I'll mute that, or you can kind of kill it there. We can kind of let it keep going if some of you guys want to continue to look at the picture quality. But basically, you can run this a bunch of different ways. And there's a couple of processors that we sell. One is this little box here, and it's got flanges on it, so you can kind of mount it on a wall or something. It's pretty clean looking. It's just got power in. It uses a DVI input, so you're coming from your feed. Whether it's Video World, you may have a switcher or a scaler, or it could just be basically a computer, like the laptop could go straight to that and go in there. And then it's got two outputs. So we're using Cat5 or Cat6 cable, and basically you're daisy chaining it. So this white cable here is coming from the back of this other processor that I have. It goes into this wall, and then it basically daisy chains, goes up, and then comes back. And that's sort of the way we kind of pass a signal along to the wall. If you have two walls, you'd have another cable going to the other wall and similar thing. The neat thing about it is that we have software that would work with this, or the other processor I'm using is this unit here, this little scaler. It's a one rack space unit, and this allows me to just use that by itself. So I don't really need the computer and this. This is the budget version. This is probably about the $829 for this little guy, plus the software that you would use that comes with it. That allows you to set up or configure the wall. So if my face is on here, my eyeball's not there, and then my other eyeball's over here in the corner, and it would kind of basically break up the picture. We want it to be smooth like this in one whole thing. So in the software, it allows you basically to tell it how you're running the wall. And basically, so it knows, it identifies each individual panel, kind of like a mailman delivering the mail to your homes in a neighborhood, and it knows exactly where everything goes so that the picture is seamless like this, and you have one nice image. The difference between the two processors, and this one is a tick under $4,000, it's around $3,900, is that this is four inputs and four outputs. So on here I have some different switches. I can basically push a button and then switch from something else. If you don't already have, let's say you might be doing camera or IMAG, you may have a couple of cameras, the pastor's walking around, maybe you have the choir and you're doing or the band's playing or something, and you're cutting back and forth between different things, or there's scripture that's going up, they may have some text. Anybody use ProPresenter? Okay, that's popular. What I'm using on that laptop, which I'll show you in a second, is MediaMaster 4. It's a little bit more for like live production and for club stuff. Some churches have bought it, but ProPresenter is really the way to go, I think, for the churches, because it's, you guys obviously know, you get a subscription and they send you content, and it's all themed around that particular month, so it's great. But that software would basically allow you to sort of rescale this as well as the MediaMaster does. This particular processor here kind of does it outputting from the laptop. I have a DVD player, so I could actually have a video in here, and that could hook up, and then I could push a button and basically switch from my laptop or the second laptop or a camera, and then bring this in, and you can just kind of, It allows you to basically have a little video control world. So it's pretty cool. And with this processor, I can go right into the face of it, and I can reconfigure my wall. So that's great for our production companies that kind of do that. Maybe they're renting a system, and each time it goes out, it's going to be a different shape and a different amount of panels. Well, their tech can go right out on the field, and in like literally a minute or two, he could configure this automatically for what he's using on that stage on that day. System comes back in, goes back out with a different guy. He can do it, same thing. It's just really easy to do. We can give you some support as well. So if you buy the products and stuff through Peach State, you can, they can call us. We can work with you. So if you have problems, if you live locally, we can travel within the states that we're at, and we can kind of help you a little bit with the setups if you're having problems. But really, it's pretty easy to go through. Power-wise, you're basically just going a power con in, and the same thing. There's an output, so it daisy chains. In this particular case, we're using like 3-foot-long cables, and the power comes into this first panel. And I do it a little bit differently, and it's because the way the sockets are on the back of the panel. So I'm going up, across, down, and doing that kind of a pattern with my power. That lets me use a short cable and not have to. We sell different length cables, but I found this is the most efficient way to be able to do that. And it gives you for a real clean look. On the back, and after lunch is done, when we come back in here, I'll take one of these pieces out, and I'll take it apart for you so you can actually see how it gets assembled or how you can, if you need to, do anything, any kind of maintenance on it. It's like literally like 3 or 4 pieces. And I'll take it apart, and you can see the back of it and actually how it looks. But there's a bunch of levers and clamps that are back here that allow you to assemble the wall, and it just goes together really, really quick. Any questions so far? The curving, yes. Good point. So on this product here, not the 6, but this 3, on the back, and I'll show you that too, that with the levers, you can adjust the wall so you can actually curve it concave or convex. So you can actually kind of, if you wanted to put it on the ground and not hang it, I wouldn't do a big wall that way, but like something that you were, like for a DJ, let's say, those guys will do that. They'll actually have it where it's kind of curving around them, and then they put their table and all their stuff there, and they can have like this cool, and they can play video along with their music, and the video's on a wall in front of them waist high. So they might actually do something that wraps around, or some of the nightclubs might do that. It could be something that you could do where you do like a semicircular cylinder in the air and have that kind of a look. You know, that could be more like in a youth room or something like that with those kids that, you want to bring them to church. They love the techie stuff. So instead of just doing a flat look, you could have it as a semi-cylinder, and then you can still put video on it or scripture. If you saw earlier, there was some graphics on there. So the graphic content, there you go there. It looks pretty good. With a 6 mil wall, this is probably too close of an image here. You'd look at it and you'll actually really see the spacing of the pixels themselves. So with a 6 mil, you probably want to be a good 30 feet or so before it really starts to kind of look good, which isn't bad. It'll still work because if you have this against a back wall, you got your stage, depending on how deep your stage is. I mean, this is maybe like 6 or 8 feet here. But then you're going to have your aisle, and then you'll have the beginning of your seats, and then you have all your pews. So all the people in the audience, it's going to look seamless for everybody that's in the audience. If you're up on stage and turning around, you can see the pixels. I can see it here, even on this one, because I'm so close. But, just coming out a few feet, and that's already looking pretty seamless from out here. So the 3 is a great product for that, and being able to kind of adjust it and be flexible just gives you more creative use. Trying to think of what else. So it's pretty simple, and like I said, afterwards, what I could do is I could disconnect. I'll actually take this panel out, so you'll see a big gap here, and I can bring this out on the table, and I could just in a couple of seconds reconfigure, and I can keep playing video on this. This will be black, and then I'll just have this out here, and you guys can kind of look around at it. So, sure. It's a dead, yeah, on this one, it's only that you have to have this rigging bar here. Now, that being said, if you're creative on the back, there are places like this wall. Actually, I don't know if you guys could probably tell, you probably can't, but there's actually a little bit of a spacing in between these. On some of them, they're seamless, and on others, they're not. We do sell a bracket, it's like $5, and it basically goes into each corner of the panels, and it pulls it all together, so to tighten it. Yeah, for this, I mean, for I'm taking it apart, bringing it down, it doesn't make sense for me to kind of do that every single time. Once you do the install, you'll definitely want to do that, and it'll really be, like, perfect. But this allows you, now, because there's holes in the back that are there for those brackets, if you can fabricate, you can make some type of a system where you can probably, it might look kind of funky, you'd have to think about it, but you might be able to kind of do it where you can mount it against something from the back and give it a support that way. Now, the elation panels that we have are able to be rear supported, right? So
those you can rear support. The biggest difference being the fact that the elation panels are not serviceable, meaning that you can get the ball components like the power supply through the power panel. This one kind of needs to have access to that.
Correct. Yeah.
So it's not as feasible.
Now, service wise, I mean, realistically, if you're talking about the product, we're not talking about service.
No, no, no.
It's
no.
Just like if the power supply does that or something like that, or if you have a power surge, you'll get it.
I'm thinking of some of our school stuff that we're working with. If we had to go in and deal with it, you know, take it back apart and down, or try to fix something. From
also,
a production standpoint, we definitely want to be stopped that way. But
yeah.
It wouldn't be rigged that way.
Also, bearing in mind that one of the realistic factors with any LED log, for the first about 120 days, you've got what we call a burn-in period. And that's where, you know, the solder joints are about the size of a hair, right? So any, you know, solder joint that's a cold solder joint or whatever, it's going to start this customer for 120 days. And so it's a time to break in the walls. Here's the walls heating up and it's cooling off and it's getting for the first time.
Here I just switched. I pushed the button and I switched to this laptop, which is running the Media Master 4 software here, the Arceus. And I just pulled up basically a layer. So this is like one graphic that's here. I can kind of put in another one. And let's see here. I would need to. Let me get it in here. Let's see here. Let's see if it will do it this way. Yeah, I'm trying to mix it in or add it in. Let's see here. Yeah. Oh, because the output. That would help. Okay. I didn't have the output selected. So it's like an audio mixer, basically, where you have a lot. You have faders and knobs that are in there. There's all different kinds of effects that you can apply to this with this software as well. So you can do some stuff. So here we have two different layers. We've got the diagonal yellow lines that are kind of doing the flash back and forth. And then we have like this pink kind of like laser beam sort of shooting through the front right there. And then you can kind of layer it. But on top of these things, you can add all sorts of other crazy effects. Without taking up a lot of time for this, I could definitely show you and dig into that. You could kind of see how that software works. If that's something that kind of interests you and you want something different maybe than the Pro Presenter, or maybe in the youth room you stick this software in there and the kids can have a blast, you know, doing stuff and making some different types of production. But this is quickly, basically I hit a button and boom, I'm back to the other video playback. So yeah. And you can kind of control the different inputs and outputs. I can scale the different things depending on what I'm actually using. So this could be set up to be one type of size. You can do picture-in-picture with it as well if you want to kind of do some of those type of creative things. Probably would work better on a bigger wall to do that. But if I go in here, let's see. So I have this set up, and here I have brightness. I go ahead and push this, and now I don't know that the difference is going to be that big. That's about 86. It does it real subtly. So that's actually at 100% now. I think you'll probably see it more on camera. It'll pick up that output, and it's probably looking like a big white glob right now because it's really, to the naked eye, your eye can kind of see the subtle adjustments. With the camera eye, it'll kind of blow it out. That's why I had it at 50, because are you streaming this live still? So I don't know what they're, if they're seeing, if it's all white, if they can see the detail or not. But I had dialed it back, and again, that's about 72%, 60.
Take it down to about 10%.
50, that's 30,
don't really notice
20. That's 10%. And we have a light, don't forget. There's this light that's up here. You have the ability to kill that? Or dim it, there you go. So now we have no frontal light, and you're really just getting, there's the ambient lighting in the room. And this is 10%.
One other thing to touch on with this, one thing that this particular controller allows you to do is it'll scale the image for you. So where your laptop or your DVD player may be outputting an HD at, 1920 by, at full HD resolution, that wall is only 512 pixels across by 256 pixels tall. So you need something to compress that image down to the size of the wall. This scaler, or this particular controller, will do that for you automatically. Just go in and turn on scaling, and it will do that for you. This one, the more budget-friendly one, does not. So you need an external scaler, and you can either do that through a third-party brand like, Folsom Screen Pro or something like that, or within the Media Master software, you can set up your output to scale it down on your output settings of your Media Master. That way, you're outputting the same resolution as the wall, so that you're not just getting a chunk of your video. Otherwise, you'd only get, basically, you get the first 512 pixels across and 256 pixels down on your laptop screen, and that would be the only image that would show up on there.
There's another thing that's a difference between the price of this and then going to this scaler, and we also have a third scaler, which is a bigger unit. It's two rack spaces. Is that this particular unit here will allow you to kind of, if you got DirecTV or some type of a video feed, that will accept it. There's like a license with it that allows that to be shown. If you try to do it here, you're just going to get a black picture. So,
and thank our wonderful digital millennium copyright protection laws
right.
For that.
And there's different ways. You'd probably need multiple units if you were going to run different feeds. So because it only does like one. But if you have any of those kind of questions, you can just, ask us. We've got our cards as well, so if you have more technical information that you need, you can contact us directly as well. Or PJ, whichever way it kind of goes through. So any more questions about any of this?
What about weight and transport?
This is 8 panels. They came in the flight case. That's we have our Roadhog, that's back there, so there's slots for 8. There's really not a whole lot of room for anything else, only the panels. There are also these little plastic caps that protect the corners on this product. It's got like 2 plastic pins, and there's magnets, and they snap on. And when you do that, that lets you put it in, and that way you don't bump the corners. We found that with people that do want to do production with this and take it apart and move it around, sometimes you damage this. Even if you put it on the ground, you might hit it too hard. Because it's delicate stuff. Like he was talking about, the solder joints are like a hair, So you'll put 8 of those in a case, and then you can find another case maybe to put the bars on. How long did it take me to throw this up? I mean, with my son, I think I did a demo, and he's 18 years old. He knows how to put this thing together. We had this whole thing, and I have truss. So this is Peach State's stuff here, but I brought truss as well. So I've got an arch, and it took me 15 minutes to assemble and wire everything. I mean, we were just blasting away just because we know how to do it and we're that comfortable with it. But
one of our customers was here yesterday, Lewis, and I don't guess you've ever done a video wall before, have you? Put one together?
No.
So he was helping him, so right. it wasn't hard at all. So, and then if you look at the Roadhog case back here, it's a very small case. Do you have it for more than 8, or you buy multiple 8 slot
right, right.
cases?
You would buy a flight case for every 8. That's the way it's
okay.
kind of we did.
And weight-wise, the panels are roughly 20 pounds a piece.
Right, they're about 20 pounds for that, yeah. These are 128 by 128 pixels because that's what we can squeeze onto this size. The AV6 is 96 by 96 pixels. And again, the pixels kind of means like the space between the pixels, how much space. So if they're wider, that means that this would kind of shoot off here. These pixels would kind of run off the end, so... based off the size of the cabinet and the way the math works out, that's the way they kind of designed it. So, but they're all basically about the same thing, and they're roughly almost like 2 foot square. I mean, they're inches. You're talking about 22 inches and 19 inches and things like that. So it's almost, it's easy if you just think about it that way. Calculate 2 feet across, you know, and vertically. And that, if you're starting to think about your church and how much space you have, just think of it that way. And then that's how you can kind of assemble. And we have some tools that they have that they can easily, like in a couple of seconds, they can put together a quote for you on what it would cost to kind of buy, you know, a panel like this or a system, you know, for a wall and plus a processor for the road cases. Actually online, if you go to ADJ, we actually have packages already on there that are kind of pre-made as well. So
one of the other nice things with ADJ Inhalation being sister brands of the same parent company, all of our video products across both lines use industry standard Novastar processors. So these are literally off-the-shelf Novastar processors. Almost 90% of the video companies out there that have video walls and whatnot will have a Novastar processor. So if, God forbid, you're out on tour and your controller goes down or something, you know, hit a power surge or somebody spills some coffee into it or whatever, you can call up the local video company, and there's a good chance that they'll have a controller they can rent you that will work with your wall. So,
yep.
Also, the guy that is our video product specialist at Elation that designs the video walls for them sits on the R&D board at Novastar in China. So he's actually an American guy, but he's on the board with them and helps them design new products and things of that nature.
Any other questions about this?
No, this is the three. So it's 3.9 millimeters from center to center on each pixel.
Yeah. And so if we're done with that, we could shut this off and kind of move over there. Chuck will take over. We got a couple of Hog consoles, a bunch of Elation lights, and a couple of ADJ lights there to kind of show you guys as well.